A packed day at Parliament, as well as prepping for a big trip to China, the Prime Minister's clearly not thrilled at having to deal with this.
Good afternoon, everybody. This morning I have advised the Governor-General to accept Michael Wood's resignation as a minister.
That's because Michael Wood has thousands of dollars of shares in Chorus and Spark, and as immigration minister he gave telecommunication technicians easier access. And then there's the tens of thousands of shares in the National Australia Bank, the BNZ's parent company. All the while, Cabinet was making a decision on a banking inquiry.
Like many others, I found this episode deeply frustrating. I was both angry and also incredibly frustrated. Repeatedly, through numerous conversations, I've asked him if there are other issues that I should be aware of, and he has said no. That's beyond frustrating.
In a statement, Michael Wood says there has not been a second of my political career where any of my financial interests have influenced my actions or even crossed my mind. And he's apologised.
I don't believe that Michael has willfully... This is still an issue that I still don't quite understand.
I'm genuinely flummoxed because I've known Michael for almost 10 years. I guess he could have a pretty good future as a stockbroker.
National says the government's facing integrity issues again.
Is this a government so incompetent that it can't follow the rules, or so arrogant that it doesn't believe that the rules apply to them?
Ministers who don't follow the rules face consequences for that.
And he's bringing in changes. Conflicts of interest will be on the Cabinet agenda every week. Reporting will now be quarterly, there will be annual in-person meetings for ministers, staff will be briefed as a second pair of eyes in every office, and if ministers don't comply, it'll be escalated to the Prime Minister straight away. Frontbench MPs will pick up the immigration, transport and health and safety portfolios.
As you know, I'm a glutton for punishment and tough work.
But Michael Wood will stay on as the MP for Mount Roskill, despite the share saga.
No, it's not right. Anyone should not do mistake again.
It took him long enough. I thought he was, I guess it's that close to an election.
If you do the crime, you should do the time.
That means time as a backbench MP.
Bring in Jess now. Jess, you talked about some stricter rules for ministers there. What else is the Prime Minister looking at?
In Australia, when you become a minister, you're not allowed to own shares in a public or a private company. So you can have the equivalent of KiwiSaver, but nothing else. And it means when you become a minister, you have to either put your shares into a blind trust so you don't know what's in it, or you have to sell them. Now, this would be a pretty drastic thing, a drastic change to our cabinet manual, but the Prime Minister is considering it because it would stop dramas like this.
You could see the frustration, Jess, on Chris Hipkins' face. How damaging is this story for the Prime Minister?
Well, you've now had Stuart Nash and Michael Wood when the Prime Minister has said to them, look, is there anything else I need to know about? They've said no, 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 and then other big things have dropped. This Michael Wood distraction has gone on for 2 weeks now, plus there's the 2 years of reminders he got from the Cabinet Office before that. And it starts to look like a pattern of behaviour. We are 4 months out from the election. This is the time the Prime Minister needs to be leading, and instead he's being kneecapped by his own ministers. When it comes to Michael Wood, he's a very popular member of the Labor Party. Until now, he's been seen as pretty squeaky clean and a safe pair of hands, and he is in that safe Labor seat in Mount Roskill, so there will be questions about whether he can claw his way back. The Prime Minister will be very keen to draw a line under the sand on this issue before he goes to China on Sunday, hoping to put a little bit of distance between himself and the ministers causing him so much grief.
Tēnei te mihi atu. Thanks very much. Political editor Jessica March-Mackay.